It's not about plug and chug through equations like a lot of the other classes. It's about understanding the need to cultivate judgment, to make well-informed decisions for which there is no clear right answer.
We teach students computer-aided design. I think the name of the course, in essence, being Design in the Real World, gives students the opportunity to really think about problems that face them each day. We really want students to think about how what they're making or how what they're looking at can be impacted by the external environment, what the pressures might be, what the temperatures might be. Building those things in the real world and testing them is really expensive, and finding those materials is really difficult. That's what the power is in this 3D simulation, because it allows our students to have firsthand experience in understanding how something might work, but without having to go out, find those materials and build them themselves.
It's the only section that's run directly by the college and not focused in any one department. We spend about the first half of the course doing a fairly comprehensive overview of all stages of the design process. They can really hit the ground running because they have that foundation. Then in the second half of the course, we shift towards applying what they learned to their course project. It spans a wide range of subject matter due to the interdisciplinary nature of the class. Oftentimes, we see students do projects relating to things that they've experienced in their lives. At this stage, it's not about the result. It's about learning the process. Unlike calculus and physics and chemistry and circuits and fluids, those things have right answers, but the design process doesn't. It has judgments that are well-informed and judgments that aren't, and that open-endedness of the design process is an important lesson for students to start learning right at the first year level in developing products or processes that solve problems and meet needs.